favorite?
Well, I can't say that. I'm just like saying, which is your favorite child, you know?
Mm-hmm.
They're all part of you.
Yeah.
I have four, I would say four that I'm proud of, and then maybe four that I think have problems, but you really love them all equally. Sometimes you're very protective of the least successful ones. And by the way, it doesn't even mean anything, because a lot of times I associate the experience I had. Like, I had a really great experience making The Immigrant and also Two Lovers and my latest film, the three experiences I love. But Lost City of Zed is a film I'm very proud of, but the experience was extremely difficult. You know, I was in the jungle and I was getting eaten by bugs and all that. So it's not really even connected to the movies themselves.
I love Little Odessa.
Well, see, that movie I barely even remember. I mean, I was 23 when I made
It's
it.
your first movie.
My very first movie, and I barely remember it. When I go, it's funny, when I have they do occasionally a retrospective, right? And they'll show the film, they'll say, well, come do a Q&A after the movie. And the last time I did it, which is a year and a half ago, I was in trouble because the audience was asking me questions. I said, I can't, does that happen in the movie? I can't remember that.
So, are you working now on a new project?
On a new project. You know, I finished this movie 6 weeks ago. No, I have nothing new yet. I'm empty right now. I got to get filled up again. No, nothing.
Can we know more details about your last project?
Well, it was as personal as I could get. It was a story from my own childhood, and I loved telling stories, bedtime stories to my children. This is before they became teenagers and started to think I was silly. And I wanted to convert one of them into a movie to be as personal as I could.
Your point of view, what's unique in Brad Pitt?
And Brad Pitt? Well, he's a movie star with movie star charisma, but he has an element of danger, actually, which is a very good thing. Sort of like Steve McQueen used to have, a kind of edge to him. And that's a rare thing. And he's also willing to be vulnerable. So all these things make for a very complex and interesting screen presence.
Are you planning to visit Egypt?
I would love to visit Egypt. Yeah, I mean, my wife and I have discussed it many times because it's a bit of a dream of ours, to be honest.
I would love to see you one day in Egypt.
I like that. Yeah, believe me, you're going to regret that. We'll stay for months and then you'll get sick of us. But I told you, my brother said it's the greatest trip he's ever taken.
The cinema industry influenced or changed after the pandemic?
It's a great question, and the answer is we don't really know yet. We have to sort of wait for the dust to settle. Right now, the audience has not fully come back. I mean, it has come back for big sort of blockbuster American films, but for the more adult type fare, the more kind of what they call specialty art film fare, it's not quite back to where it was. And we just have to keep working and make sure the audience remembers what it means to go to the movies.
Mr. James, thank you so much for your time. We are so happy to have you with us.
It's great to be here. Thank you.